Hello and welcome to India Tonight. I'm Karan Thapar. The arrest and prosecution of the former Gujarat Minister of State for Home, Amit Shah, by the CBI has ballooned into a serious political controversy. The BJP claims this is a vendetta ultimately designed to target Chief Minister Narendra Modi. And the possibility that the Sohrabuddin case may eventually be moved out of Gujarat is seen as an insult to the state as well as the Gujarat judiciary. So today we ask, how credible are these allegations? With me, BJP spokesperson Prakash Javadekar, former CBI director Joginder Singh, the human rights activist Teesta Setalvad, and Congress leader of the opposition in Gujarat, Shaktisinh, Gohil. Would you accept that the BJP suspicion is supported by the argument that many people believe that in the Mayawati case, the Lalu Yadav case, the Mulayam Singh cases, the CBI changed its position to reflect requirements of the government of the day? And given that it's happened there, why do you think it's not happening in the Amit Shah case?
Look, Mr. Thapar, here is totally a different scenario. There is no role of Congress party in the entire episode. This is the case between Honorable Supreme Court, CBI, and as an accused. Matter is not disposed of. Matter is still pending before the Supreme Court, wherein the Gujarat government is party before the Supreme Court. Now, if Mr. Javadekar or if Mr. Narendra Modi or BJP has some problem, or they think that there is something is going wrong, if there is something wrong, which is the forum to go and argue? That is the Supreme Court. They are shouting before the crowd, putting allegation before the camera, but not moving to the Supreme Court.
Which is very interesting. I'll take that point up in a moment's time. But first, Teesta Setalvad, does someone pressure anyone being questioned by the CBI is under? It's not unique to Amit Shah. Let me put it like this. Are you at all worried that with the CBI being refused custody, they may not be able to build a watertight case and you might end up, in fact, acquitting the man, which would be hugely embarrassing for Congress?
Let me tell you one thing, that first is CBI could have kept Amit Shah for 24 hours behind bars. The CBI had all powers to keep Amit Shah in police custody for 24 hours.
And they could have questioned him during that time, but yes, they chose not to.
They didn't.
That's what the court pointed out.
Right. And
Was that a mistake?
Yes, I'll tell you one thing.
Was it a mistake?
No, that wasn't a mistake, but that was CBI being too fair to the case, and thereafter CBI chose to question him in a judicial custody.
It's very interesting. I like the language you use, the CBI being too fair.
Yeah.
You mean so fair that they've ended up damaging the case?
Not damaging the case, but they choose rather than a police custody.
You could always get for the police custody.
Within 14 days, Mr. Thapar, legally, I'll just tell you one thing, that within 14 days, investigation agency at any point of time can ask for a police custody. So CBI
has been refused. They've gone in appeal, but it's been refused. That's the point I'm making.
It is pending before the higher forum.
Well, you've got no guarantee the higher forum will agree.
I'm sure. Legally, yes. I'm being an advocate. I know that legally CBI will get custody.
I have to point out that you're also the leader of the opposition,
yes,
and we must temper your advocacy with that, bearing that fact in mind. Let me put it like this, Teesta. It is important that not only must justice be done, but justice has to seem to be done. In this instance, is there a danger that Amit Shah is being perceived as someone to whom justice is not being done? And may that rebound on the CBI to the benefit of the BJP and the embarrassment of Mr. Goyal's party?
No, see, I'll tell you one thing. It was March 19th this year, March 19th, 2010, that the CBI first issued a summons to Amit Shah. It was not issued just last week or the week before. March 19th, summons was issued for normal questioning, not for arrest. He, after that, being MOS home, did not attend official meetings, stayed away from Sachivalaya, did not come. He was virtually on the run. A minister on the run from his own seat of power.
Well, now, he wasn't on the run, but he wasn't accessible and available for questioning.
But Karan, we are both journalists as well, and when you see a person who's a MOS home is not available for questioning.
Except that the CBI could have arrested him at that point.
Then we would have said that they're being arresting without questioning. So I'm just saying it's like a circular situation.
But the point is they're still arresting without questioning.
Because they had no option, because at the point they had to file a charge sheet within 90 days.
They collected the evidence of the people
yeah.
who have given statement before.
So then if they didn't have evidence, they didn't really need to question him either.
No, they first collected the intelligence.
They had suspicion at that point.
They first collected the evidence and then they went ahead to question.
But there's a wider point which I want to bring out, which I'm saying that this very bulky charge sheet that the CBI has filed, of which we've seen glimpses, all of us have seen glimpses of it. I think what's really revealing about this charge sheet is something that is truly embarrassing the BJP. It is an extortionist racket. It is not an AK-47 wielding terrorist Sohrabuddin. That's the point. This racket of extortionists.
But remember, we're talking about a charge sheet no one's seen. We're only talking about leaks of that charge sheet. So let's leave that aside because we don't want to do damage to someone on the basis of leaks that may turn out to be wrong.
No,
the point I'm making. The point I'm making is the one I want to come back to. Do you think in the handling of this case, an impression is being created that justice is not being seen to be done? And might that rebound in Amit Shah's favor? You may end up building sympathy for the man rather than establishing his guilt.
I personally feel that the BJP's tactics outside the Supreme Court, instead of arguing the point in the Supreme Court, outside the court, is trying to actually create an atmosphere of the kind you're talking about. But I think
that's
the ordinary...
That's not a stupid thing for them to try and do. It might be sensible.
No, it may be, but I think it is going to boomerang. I think it's not working. I think the people are questioning the fact as to why they are so scared to face the law.
Let's take a break at that point.